We're actually in the corner this time. Schoolsfirst, FCU, of course. Jonathan Wesson joining. Thanks for being here. You're up in the Folsom Branch. Not too long of a drive for you down here,
right? Not too bad.
Welcome back. I'm glad we're in the corner talking about things that because you guys are always in people's corner at Schoolsfirst.
Absolutely.
We want to talk today about person-to-person payment. I think people know all these apps that they're using on their phone. There's a lot of them now. It used to be just one. Now it seems like I have seven different options. And today we want to talk about some of the risks, I think, some of the ways that people can sometimes be taken advantage of using these apps. So Jonathan, kick us off a little bit. Tell us kind of the state of the affairs right now.
Absolutely. So these have become very popular, just kind of in society. Almost everybody has some type of person-to-person payment app on their phone. Yep. It's very fast, it's very convenient, but at the same time, that's also very, open a lot of doors for the scammers,
for
right?
Sure.
It's fast and convenient for you to send that money out, and so they're right there at the door trying to trick you into ways to get that money sent to them.
And is it that it's just easy, and so people who are looking to defraud others, why is that door open for people who are doing that?
Well, so through the person-to-person payment apps, there's no protections. Like if you were to be using one of the like a credit card, right? So if they can trick you into sending them the money, that money's gone. You can't go to the bank and file a dispute to get that money back. Now, hopefully, in time, we'll get some regulations from a government level that will help protect people in these events of scams, get that money reimbursed.
Sure.
But as of right now, it's up to each
individual.
Each individual has to kind of be aware and protect themselves.
Because with credit cards, we were afforded certain protections through, you know, credit card fraud and whatnot. This is a digital payment, so it is a little classified differently.
Yeah, the nature of the person-to-person itself is more like a cash transaction. And so there's not any additional protections that have been created at this time if you are scammed.
Okay. What are some of the common scams that you guys at Schoolsfirst are seeing and helping people through? I'm sure you're picking up on these all the time.
Unfortunately, we deal with a lot of scams pretty consistently. And there's a lot of different scams. There's new ones being created every day. The common theme that we see in the scams is they trick you into sending their money by creating a sense of urgency. You have to take care of this right now. And if you don't, there's some type of negative repercussion that comes along with that. So an example of that might be like you get a text or message on your phone that says, hey, I'm from the utility company. Your last payment didn't go through, and if you don't send us money right now, we're going to shut off your power immediately. And you kind of freak out.
Yeah.
And so you get on there and you do it, you follow their instructions, and the next thing you know, there was nothing wrong with your utility bill. So when you get those messages that are seeking that urgent resolution,
sure,
you really need to be cautious and aware of that.
In terms of protection before you run, what's the best way that you're telling people to protect themselves against these types of fraudulent behaviors and people?
Really, it's all about creating awareness. Most commonly what you're going to see is they're going to be trying to ask you for like your account credentials or creating some type of urgent payment. Most legitimate businesses and organizations do not interact with their customers that way.
That's right.
So if you're getting pressure to send this information through a payment, person-to-person payment type app, and that's the only thing that they're gonna accept, that should be a red flag for you right there to stop.
Big
and
red
contact
flag.
That business off of their information from their website. Don't reply to the information that's been sent to you.
Good call.
And then I would also say, keep those app services to your friends and your family, the people that you personally know and trust. Don't use it for strangers.
Good tips, man. Jonathan, always coming with the great info. We'll put up a little information about Schoolsfirst Federal Credit Union, over 70 locations and growing throughout California. Call them up, hit them online, and just send money to your friends or me, I guess. You could send money to me. Or Mr. Foodtastic.
There you go.
You could send him and buy some watermelon salad.